Are you trying to make a video where you're watching another video but talking about that video as you're making a video? Yeah, I know I've said video a lot, but if you're trying to do something like this where you can play a video on the side of your scene, then I'm going to show you how to do this all in Ecamm Live, the number one video creation and content creation software on the Mac. So let's start off with understanding that there are two different ways to accomplish this. The first one is you're going to add a shared screen overlay to your Ecamm Live scene. And the second one is you're going to add a shared app window. Very similar steps, however, it depends on what your goal is and how many videos you want to play, and one may be easier than the other. Now, the next thing you need to understand is that there are a couple of requirements for when you are doing this type of a scene. The first one is that you need to wear headphones or you need to enable echo cancellation, because when you're hearing that video playing, if you're listening to it through your speakers, then your microphone is going to pick up that audio. Now, I do suggest that you wear headphones so that you get the best quality audio from your microphone. However, if you do not have headphones or you just cannot wear them, then that's totally okay. Go ahead and listen to the videos as you're playing them through your normal speakers, but you have to make sure that you enable echo cancellation in your sound levels panel. Now, if you're trying to figure out how to do that, then just go ahead and click up over here and you're going to see a link on how to watch how the sound panels works in Ecamm Live and how to enable echo cancellation. The second requirement that you need to do to make this work is that you need to have your system audio share enabled inside of Ecamm Live. And that allows Ecamm Live to capture the system audio as the video is playing. It's also coming through to your Ecamm Live production. All right, so first up, let's do this with a shared display. What that means is I have my main computer display that's running Ecamm Live, and then I've got a separate computer display that is running a video in full screen. And in this example, as you can see right here, I'm running this second display playing YouTube video, which is right now running full screen. So if I double click on that video, you can see it's really just a computer shared display. So here's my Ecamm Live interface. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the plus sign to create a blank canvas for yourself. Now, if you see your camera view in here, go ahead and go to top bar menu source and click on blank. The next thing you want to do here is you want to add your camera, and that is my main cam link over here. And I'll just move this over to the side for now. The next thing you want to do is add that screen share overlay. Now, by default, my other screen is already configured and chosen here, but if it's picking the wrong display, then you can go ahead and click on this little pencil icon and choose the other display that you have that full screen video YouTube playing in your browser. So I'm just going to go and expand that. And I know that I want to make things a little bit smaller here so that the video is a little bit bigger. And let's move that around like that. And perfect. So now it allows me to go ahead and put my video to the side. Now you can see that I've got the YouTube browser. You can see all the top and the headers and stuff like that, but I don't want you to see all of that. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to just double click on the YouTube video and make that full screen. Now you can see, yes, you can see the bottom and the top where you're looking at the overlay on YouTube, but that's completely okay because that will disappear once you play the video and move your mouse away from that screen. But the next thing that we have to do is we actually have to get the Ecamm Live application to hear or to route your audio from the browser over to your production. So the next thing we want to do is we want to make sure that you have sound capturing or capture system audio enabled. Now I have it to when sharing the screen. So that means when I have an overlay that's sharing the screen or the entire scene shares the screen, I have the option to enable the system audio to be routed through Ecamm Live. Otherwise, the other option is to set it to all the time, but I don't always want the audio to come through. So I'm going to go ahead and leave that to when sharing the screen, and I'm going to click on this overlay here. And I want to make sure that Activate System Audio Capture is checked. Now, what that does is it creates a new audio channel here called All System Audio, and I have the option to go ahead and choose just the Brave browser or whichever application that is, or just leave it as All System Audio. And what that does is it just anything that's playing, even your alerts and your Outlook chimes and dings, that will come through. So you just have to make sure that you close those applications. But once you do that, then all you have to do is click on the video to start playing. So I'm just going to go back into full screen here, and you can see this is what the production or the recording is going to look like. And as I move my mouse and click on play, What does your remote guest kit look like and sound like in the real world, Daniel? That's the question that a lot of people ask me after this. Now, I can go ahead and use the mouse to click on the video to play it and to pause it, or I can also use the play pause on my Mac keyboard.
Last video, if you want to watch it, go ahead and click on that link up there. So right now,
and then when I'm finished commenting, I can just go back into full screen and talk about my thoughts and comments about this, and then move back over to the scene and then hit play on the keyboard.
And this is the built-in webcam. Pretty good, not great, but...
All right, so that is the first option. Now, the second option is where you are now using an application to play your videos. So you can go ahead and open your video inside of QuickTime or VLC Player, which is probably my more favorite video because it allows you to add a playlist. So as you can see here on the shared desktop, I've now got this VLC player running. Now I have multiple videos that I may want to show inside of my production. And so now with VLC, I can have a playlist, whereas other applications like QuickTime, the playlist is not necessarily as easily accessible or configurable. So if I want to play this video, I can go ahead and hit play.
So you're using Ecamm Live and you're trying to...
It is going to start in a window. So all I have to do is double click on the video in VLC and it will go full screen. Now, just like as if I was playing the YouTube video by clicking on the video to start and stop it, the exact same thing I can do when
How the heck do I show
using the VLC player, right? Or because VLC is the active application and it was the last one that was playing the video, I can go ahead and use my keyboard to press play and pause as well.
A PowerPoint presentation or a keynote presentation.
And that's it. Super, super simple. In just a few minutes, you're now able to create video commentaries on the fly. Now, of course, this demonstration that I just showed you was using a secondary display on my computer system. Now, if you're a content creator and you still only have one display available on your system and you're trying to figure out, well, how do I show this using one display? You're going to use the exact same system and methodology that I use to show a PowerPoint or a keynote presentation. And to watch that video, you want to go click right over here. And by the way, we've got so many more different Ecamm Live trainings. So when you're ready to watch the rest of them, click on this bottom playlist because that's where you're going to get all the good stuff.